Let me start.
Yes.
Let me start. With your permission?
Yeah.
Okay. You have permission?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, thank you. Thank you, sir. There are two lectures of mechanism of action of Harvard.
Okay.
Don't come to me at the end of the lecture, what is important for the MCQs and what are this. Okay? I will tell you here and you should know it. All right? And I think that you will be okay in the exam. All right? So there are two lectures. One is the steroid mechanism of action. There are two types of hormones. Steroid hormones and the other hormones. So I think we have lecture one.
Yes.
Go. So Dr. Mehta has taken that. And that's the more difficult part of this mechanism. This one is very easy. This is really easy. These are our objectives. Basically, if I will take this lecture, it's only 2 or 3 slides. Okay? But for the lecture, I have made 22 slides. These are objectives. So, the first is hormones that bind to intracellular receptors. There are two words, intercellular and intracellular. What are these two terminology? Intracellular.
Sorry.
When there is the intracellular, then it is inside the cell. Inside the cell. Okay? This is. If it is inside, then it is intracellular. Intracellular. If it is intercellular, I-N-T-E-R, intercellular, not intra. If it is intercellular, then between the two cells. Between the two cells. Okay, so intracellular is what?
Inside the cell.
So these are hormones where their receptors are inside the cells. And Dr. Mehta has taken the lecture, those hormones receptors are outside the cell. They are on the membrane, cell membrane. And these hormones are inside the cell. These hormones are, the hormone receptors are inside the cell. So we have distinction now. Dr. Vidal's lecture was, the receptors were where? On the plasma membrane, outside. And here in this steroid and thyroid hormones, cytoplasm and nucleus, inside the cell. Okay, these are, can we? Can it not be up? It's okay for you?
Yes.
Okay. So, what are the characteristics of these receptors? Characteristics?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Characters. What are the characters of these receptors or hormones? These hormones, they are steroids. They are lipophilic. What do I mean by lipophilic? Which are soluble in lipid. What do I mean by hydrophilic? What are hydrophobic? Which are not soluble in water. Okay. So lipophilic means soluble in lipid. Okay. So these hormones, steroid and thyroid hormones, they are soluble in lipids. This is first characteristics. Second is they need transport to carry them in the blood. They need transport. What type of transport?
Protein.
What? No. They need transport, and the transport is, I did not show here, transport is globulin, pre-albumin, and albumin. these three things are they are the proteins which where the thyroid hormones are formed in thyroid glands, okay, and that how they are transported into the target tissue. How they bind, they cannot travel alone. Alone thyroid or steroid hormones, they cannot travel in the blood. So can you come to the college by foot? You cannot. You need car. So yeah. Okay. So steroid hormones, thyroid hormones cannot travel in the blood alone. So what they need? They need carrier. They need carrier. So they need carrier. What type of carriers are these three proteins are act as carriers? Globulin, steroid hormone or thyroid hormone bind with it. Thyroid hormone bind with it. Thyroid hormone bind with it. Or steroid hormone bind with it. Steroid hormone. Okay. Approximately 70% is bound with this globulin. 15% with this, 15% with this. Okay? What is the point here? Point here is that steroid hormone and thyroid hormone, they cannot travel in the blood alone. Alone they cannot travel. So how they travel in the blood? How they travel? They bind with proteins. They bind with proteins. Now the question is, which protein? These three proteins, globulin, prealbumin and albumin. Okay? So if we take thyroid for example, so thyroid hormones 70% is bound with thyroglobulin. The molecule is thyroglobulin. And that's prealbumin and albumin 15% and 15%. Okay? So you got the point now? Steroid and thyroid hormones, they are lipophilic. They are soluble in the lipid. They cannot travel in the blood alone. So what they need? They need carrier or they need transporter. Okay? Carrier or transporter. What are the carriers and what are the transporters? These three proteins are transporters or carriers. Okay? Alright. So this point is this, and the second is they have long plasma half-life. What do I mean by half-life? Everything which is formed in our body, it has to be destroyed. As the man, when we born, we have to die, whether at the young age or whether at the old age. Okay. Likewise, all the molecules which are produced in our body, they have to be destroyed. Their life, for example, they will destroy in 20 hours, so their half-life will be 10 hours. So half-life is where half of the molecule is destroyed. The time, what is the half-life? Half-life is the time at which half of the substance is destroyed. For example, our body produced 10 milligram of thyroid. So we will see that how much time it takes to destroy the 5 milligram. How much total was produced? 10. Okay? So we will see that 5 milligram will destroy in 25 minutes. Okay? So this will be half-life. 25 minutes will be half-life. So if we destroy all this, it will take how much time? 50 minutes. So this is half-time. At the time at which most of the half of the substance is destroyed. That is called half-life. They make, of course, their action starts. Dr. Mithun told you that hormone comes, bind with the membrane, and then there is a second messenger, cyclic AMP, and etc., etc. Then there is a long cascade there. in Dr. Vidhan's lecture. But here, they only act when they bind with the receptor and direct action. So they are not the first messengers. No second messenger. You know second messenger?
Cyclic
AMP. Yes, yes. Cyclic AMP as well. If I give attendance to, what's your name?
Nawaf.
If I give attendance to Nawaf, I am first messenger. He is giving attendance to Dr. Gamal Pakhar. He is second messenger. Attendance is message. Attendance is message. So here it is different. You will see that when the hormone receptor binds, they act directly. Okay. So they are opposite. They are opposite. This slide is opposite to the steroid and thyroid hormones. Thyroid and steroid hormones, opposites. You have already lectured about these slides, so I will not go in detail. But they have opposite actions of steroid and thyroid hormones. Their receptors are on the membrane. They do not need transport proteins. They can travel in the blood alone, and they have a short half-life. They need second messenger. These are the examples. Okay. This slide is repetition of the previous slides. If you see repetition, but I put it there deliberately myself. Why? I can ask you the question. Compare the receptors, two receptors. So you will, if you will write like this way, I'll give you full marks. Okay? So this slide is for the exam, not for, this is repetition. If you see here, this is repetition. This solubility, lipophilic, they are hydrophilic. Transport proteins, they don't need transport, they need transport. Okay, they don't need transport, they need transport. Plasma I5, short, long. Receptors, intracellular, plasma membrane. So this is what? This is repetition of the previous slides. Repeat. So I made it just for the comparison. What are the plasma membrane receptors and what are the intracellular receptors? Okay. So you will write like this. Okay? Please don't expect me that if you say that, oh, look, I have written this. No. I want, if I need comparison, I need this way. Okay? This slide is almost repeated, but here there is that they are protein in nature, receptors. These are receptors. For previously they were hormones. Now we are talking about receptors. Receptors, what is the nature of the receptors? They are proteins. They are proteins. They are proteins in nature, or they reversibly binds. They reversibly bind to hormones. What do I mean by this? They bind like this, do their function and disassociate. This is called a reversible. For example, look at me. I am going this way, and this is, I'm coming this way. This is reversible. Okay? I'm going this way and coming this way. This is a reversible. If I go here and I cannot come back, then it is irreversible. Okay? So reversible is what? They bind with the receptors and then disassociate. Alright? So they are reversibly bind to hormones. They are specific. One receptor per hormones. One receptor, for example, glucocorticoid receptor cannot bind with thyroid receptor. Okay? So they have their specific receptors. Every hormone has specific receptors. alright? Sensitive. There are two words here, specificity and sensitivity. They are very sensitive. If a slight conformational change, what do I mean by conformational change? Change in the structure. Change in the structure. A conformational change. Conformation is a little bit different than structure, but normally we say structurally different. For example, this is one molecule, and if it is like this, this is conformational change, and if it is like this, this is original form. For example, this is original form, this is original form. Look at my hand, and it comes like this, this is conformational change. No molecule is out, no molecule is added. Only shape has been changed. Only shape has been changed. Look at it. This is molecule. It comes like this. This is conformational change. So slight conformational change. Slight conformational change make them insensitive. Okay. For example, these insulin receptors. How do you get the insulin resistant? How you get diabetes? There are a slight change. Structure of receptors. Insulin cannot bind with the receptor. So you get insulin resistant. You get diabetes later on. Okay. So again, these are the repeated slides, but I want this way to write in the exam. There are two receptors. There are two receptors. They have compared here. Okay. But I have made only example. You will write all the points. Okay? If it is 5 points, you will write 5 points. The difference between receptors. Okay. They may be, as you know, Dr. Bidhan's lecture, membrane associated. They may be within the cell membrane. They may be here, they may be here, they may be like this, and they may be here. This is cytoplasm. They may be here, this is nucleus, okay? So there are three or four positions. One is on the cell membrane, other is embedded in the cell, embedded. Have you heard this word?
Yes, sir.
Embedded, half outside, half inside, embedded in the cell. Yeah. And then there are some which are in the cytoplasm, there are some which are on the nucleus. Okay. This has been done. So steroid hormones, they are very small. They are hydrophobic. Hydrophobic means they are not soluble in the water, they are soluble in the lipids, travel in blood via carriers, same thing. Cytoplasmic are nuclear receptors. They don't have receptors on the cell membrane. Steroid receptors are within the cytoplasm. Within the cytoplasm. And they change protein synthesis and through transcription. They are derived from the cholesterol. Very important. Very important. They are derived from cholesterol. And again, the same thing. Travel carrier, long half-life, binds to cytoplasm and nuclear receptors. They act as first messenger. So this is the mechanism action, the main slide. This is the main slide of this lecture. Okay. Hormone is created or produced in the gland, where the steroid hormones or thyroid hormones will produce in the glands. Then they will release in the blood. This is the blood. This is the blood. But hormone cannot travel alone. It binds with the carrier protein. What are the carrier proteins?
Globulin,
prealbumin, and albumin. They bind with the carrier. Then the carrier becomes here. The carrier is left out, and this hormone get enter into the cytoplasm. When it get enter into the cytoplasm, it bind with the receptors. These receptors are found in the cytoplasm. These are receptors they found in the cytoplasm. Let's take again. Come with me. This is hormone produced in the blood, in the gland, and cannot travel alone. So it binds with carrier. It binds with globulins, prealbumin, or albumin, and it goes to the cell where carrier is out. Carrier cannot enter into the cell. Okay? Only hormones enter into the cell, and then the hormone receptor binds with each other. Hormone receptor binds with each other. It makes complex. This hormone, this is receptor. This is a complex. Now, this complex is translocated into the nucleus. What is the word? Translocated. Transport. What do I mean by transport? Transport. From here, from college to the city. Transport. Translocation means from one location to the other location. So, it is translocated from cytoplasm to the nucleus. Now, when it gets entered into the nucleus, it binds here at the promoter region. This is the what? This is promoter region. This is promoter region of DNA. This is the DNA. Then the receptor and hormone complex binds with the DNA. And it affects the transcription. What is the transcription? The synthesis of messenger RNA. When it affects messenger RNA, from messenger RNA, we make proteins. When we make proteins, you get the response. I mean function. Okay? Should I say again?
No. Doctor?
Clear?
On the DNA, Gonadal region. Gonadal region.
Gonad?
Region of the DNA.
The region of DNA, promoter region.
Promoter.
P-R-O-M-O-T-O-R. Promoter. Promoter. This is the promoter region. And again, within the promoter region, there is a hormone responsive element. It will come probably in some other slides, but here, this region, where this part of DNA, where this hormone and this combines are attached, this is called promoter region. And in the promoter region, there is hormone responsive element. What is this? Hormone responsive element. Okay? So it binds with the hormone responsive element here. Hormone responsive elements, then it affects the synthesis of messenger RNA. When the messenger RNA synthesis is affected, then protein synthesis is affected and the functions are altered, or the functions are done. Let's say again, the steroids or thyroid hormones are produced where? They are produced in the gland. And I told you that they cannot travel alone in the blood. As you cannot travel without CR. They cannot travel without globulin, albumin, or prealbumin. Okay? They bind with the carrier. What is this carrier? These are proteins. Okay? They bind with the carrier, travel in the blood, goes to the cell. Here, carrier remains outside. Carrier remains outside of the cell. Hormone gets entered into the cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, there are receptors. The hormone attach with the receptors. So it is a now complex. What is the complex? Hormone and receptor complex. This is translocated from cytoplasm to nucleus. And in the nucleus, it binds with the promoter region. But specifically promoter region, HRE, hormone responsive element. When it binds with the hormone responsive element, it affects the synthesis of messenger RNA. When the messenger RNA synthesis is affected, protein synthesis occurs, and then the functions of proteins are started in the cell. Anything which is not clear?
No, it's clear.
It's clear. This one slide. This one. Okay. This is, I skipped this because this is the same. This is the same. This is free hormone. This is transport proteins. So it travels in the blood with the carrier proteins, and that carrier remains in the blood, and hormones enter in the cells. It makes complex with the receptors. Receptor complex attach on the HRE. HRE means on the promoter region, and then it affects the messenger RNA and the proteins. So that's why yes. That previous slide is enough. Previous slide. That's why I skipped. Now let's take the whole. There are heat shock proteins. Which proteins? Heat. There are some hormones which are found free in the cytoplasm. Free in the cytoplasm. And there are other hormones which in the cytoplasm are already bound with the heat shock proteins. With heat shock proteins. I will show this slide. You will understand. So the heat shock proteins remains bound with the receptor until hormone comes. When hormone comes, for example, this is receptor. This is heat shock protein. Okay. This red one is heat shock protein. This is receptor. Where these receptors are found? In the cytoplasm. There are heat shock proteins. Heat shock proteins which bind with these receptors. Okay, then it remains bound. It is now the receptor is inactive. Receptor is inactive. Now what happens? Hormone comes. Hormone remove this and attach itself. Now the blue one is hormone. Okay, the heat shock proteins are removed. So there are some hormones, as you will see in the next slides. They act via heat shock proteins, and there are some others which act without heat shock proteins. I have already told you what is the role of heat shock proteins. They remain attached with the receptors until the hormone comes. Until the hormone comes and remove it and bind with the receptor. Okay? You will understand this slide more here. Now you see, this is hormone. How it reaches here? By the carrier, by the proteins. Okay? Now the hormone gets entered into the cytoplasm. Okay, and the receptor is bound with the heat shock proteins. This is the receptor, and this is heat shock protein. Receptor is bound with the heat shock proteins, and it is inactive. When the hormone comes, the heat shock protein is removed, and the hormone is bound with the receptor. Hormone is bound with the receptor. Now, this hormone receptor complex, it enter into the cytoplasm and as a nucleus, where it binds another hormone receptor. You see here two dimer. It makes dimer. This is hormone receptor. It will attach another hormone receptor complex, so it becomes dimer. Dimer means two. One means unit. So two units of receptors, two units of hormones. Two hormones, two receptors here. They bind with each other and bound on the DNA. And bound on the DNA again on where? Hormone responsive element. When they bound here, what they do? They affect the messenger RNA synthesis and then the same story. Okay? So you got now what are the heat shock proteins role? Heat shock proteins are found. Heat shock proteins are found in the cytoplasm. They are usually found with the receptors. When the receptors do not function, they are attached with the heat shock proteins. Now the receptors are inactive. All right. Now, what happens when hormone comes? This heat shock protein is removed. Hormone binds with the receptor. Okay. And then this receptor and hormone get entered into the cell, make dimer. Two units of receptor, two of hormones, and then it binds with the HRE DNA and it affects the messenger RNA synthesis. Not all the receptors are bound with heat shock proteins. Okay, I told you. I have given the examples here. Some receptors are bound with the heat shock proteins, others do not. Okay, I have one slide. They will give you the example. Now, we have big example, glucocorticoid action. Glucocorticoid action, the receptor of glucocorticoid hormone, they are bound with the heat shock proteins. They are bound with the heat shock proteins and in the cytoplasm. Okay, heat shock proteins are 90 HSP, heat shock proteins 90, or I did not show it, 70 as well. Heat shock protein 70, this is name of the heat shock protein. Heat shock protein 90, heat shock protein 70. Okay, so if you remember this alone, it will be accepted. Okay, the heat shock proteins are there, they are attached in the cytoplasm with the glucocorticoid receptors. Heat shock proteins are bound with what?
Receptors.
When the glucocorticoid comes, hormone comes, heat shock proteins will be removed. Heat shock proteins will be removed and glucocorticoid will attach with the receptor. Now this will go into the nucleus and make two units, dimer. And where this dimer will attach? On the HRE, and it will affect the synthesis of messenger RNA. Okay, same I have already told you. Yeah, there are actually this glucocorticoid, they act by two ways. This is very important. This transactivation and transrepression. Transactivation is transactivation means it increases the synthesis of messenger RNA. It increases the synthesis of messenger RNA. Transactivation. Transactivation means it when hormone and receptor bounds, they attach with HRE. That increase the synthesis of messenger RNA. So this is transactivation. What is the transrepression? Transrepression is the stoppage of the synthesis of messenger RNA. Stop. The synthesis, messenger RNA synthesis is stopped. How it stopped? It does not, in this case, I will say 10 times, in this case. In this case, transrepression case, okay, the glucocorticoid does not bind with the DNA. It binds with the transcriptional factor and stops the RNA synthesis. Okay, so this is called transrepression. Transactivation is? It increases the synthesis of messenger RNA. What is the transrepression? It stops the synthesis of messenger RNA. But how it stops? It binds with transcriptional factor, so it stops RNA synthesis. What is the time? We have time? Okay. Look at it. All the proteins, it should be done before. But I don't know. I have put it here. These hormones have bound with the heat shock proteins. These hormones, examples. These are the examples of the hormone receptors which bound with what? with heat shock proteins. And these are the examples which do not bind with the heat shock proteins. The only one thing, these hormones bound with the heat shock proteins. And these hormones do not, hormone receptors do not bind with the heat shock proteins. The same thing. This I have already told you. So no need. This is the steroid superfamily, all the names here. It's just names. Steroid superfamily, yes. Okay, so these are the steroid superfamily which acts, their receptors are there. Their receptors are in the cytoplasm or in the nucleus. Or in the nucleus. Nuclear receptors. Now we have told you the cytoplasmic receptors. They are nuclear receptors. Where are they found? They are not found here. They are found in the nucleus. In the nucleus. We call it, if you do take DNA like this, this is 3', this is 5'. So these are bound with this region. This region. But it's not necessary for you to learn. You can only learn that their receptors are in the nucleus and on the HRE, bound with the HRE. What is HRE? Hormone responsive element. What was the steroid hormones? They were translocated from the cytoplasm in the nucleus. But here, nuclear, they are already found on where? HRE. They are already found on HRE. So you can see the next slide. Yeah, I don't know why. Can we do it here somewhere? On this side? Can we do it? From where?
Skip.
Yeah, okay, it will do. These are the hormones which have nuclear receptors. Which have nuclear receptors. T3, T4, you know them. Trihydrothiodine and tetrahydrothiodine. But this is cytoplasm. It will go in the nucleus. So you can see here, receptors are found here. Receptors are found here. This is HRE region. This is HRE region. So they are already found on the HRE. These receptors are found where? On the HRE. HRE, hormone responsive element. These hormones are found on the hormone responsive element. Okay, so the hormone comes and again at same way it affects the messenger RNA synthesis and then the protein synthesis. Okay, this is the summary of it. Again, I will say that there are hormones which are produced in the gland. But they cannot travel alone in the blood. So they need carrier. Carriers are thyroglobulin, prealbumin, albumin. And in the blood, it carries them and then hormones get enter into the cell. There are two receptors, two type of receptors here. One is found in the cytoplasm and the other on the nucleus. So the thyroids are nuclear receptors. Thyroids are nuclear receptors. And the steroids are? Cytoplasmic receptors. In the cytoplasm, they bind with their receptors. Then receptor hormone complex is translocated inside the nucleus and they bound with HRE and affects the synthesis of RNA. Okay. I can say that only 5 lines left. Only 5 lines left. These are hormones which are hydrophobic. They are soluble in the lipid. They have a long half-life and they need carrier and they have receptors in the cytoplasm or in the nucleus. In the cytoplasm, there are two types of receptor, one bound with the heat shock proteins, others do not. Okay, and the thyroid hormones have receptors on the nucleus, and both of them affect messenger RNA synthesis and protein synthesis. Any question?
Thank you.
Promoter region contains hormone responsive elements. Promoter region is big one. Go like this. Promoter region. And HRE is like here. If this is promoter region from this hand to this hand, and my neck is HRE, hormone responsive element. So HRE is a small part of promoter region, and promoter region is part of DNA. So in fact, they bind with the DNA.
اسمع هلا خلص من المحاضرة.
You can there will be two receptors, two hormones. There will be two receptors. But there, for example, this one is a receptor. This is hormone. It goes inside the nucleus. Then there is another receptor and hormone. It goes also in the nucleus. Then they bind with each other and bound on the DNA. But same from the cytoplasm. There are two molecules of receptors and two molecules of hormones. One hormone binds with one receptor, and the other hormone binds with the other receptor. Both are translocated from cytoplasm to nucleus. They make a dimer there and binds with the DNA. Where the DNA, which part of DNA is promoter region, and which is the specific part of HRE, hormone responsive elements. Yeah. There was one professor, lady professor in Pakistan. They teach here. The girls are sitting here. The boys are sitting. Very attractive, huh? So doesn't matter. Half sight girls and half sight boys. Okay. And the girls teachers are also teach. And one teacher was telling them, taking this lecture. And she was telling them, human resource element, HRE is what? He said that, she said, that human resource element. I was going out and give her a pat. I said, professor, it is not a human resource element, it is hormone responsive element. What is it? What is it, HRE? Hormone responsive element. Hormone responsive element. Where this hormone responsive element is found?
Promoter region.
Where this promoter region is found?
Yeah.
On the DNA. Finished.